We have heard of the term flagship killer, and the next one that will probably leave an impression in your mind would be selfie expert, a term which Oppo has been proudly using since a year ago and continues to believe that it will stay strong by selling phones that take great selfies. Not too long ago, Oppo launched the successor to the original selfie expert. The Oppo F1S brings the term to the next level with an upgraded front-facing camera and beautified 4.0 software. I have to admit that I was very skeptical of how Oppo intends to market this device purely as a selfie shooter, rather than focusing on design and performance like the rest. So, what does the Oppo F1S has to offer in being a smartphone and a selfie shooter? Let's find out. I wouldn't blame you if you think we are reviewing the Oppo F1 Plus, because the F1S looks very identical to the former. Unlike previous Oppo phones I've reviewed, the F1S design is nothing extraordinary. It has a metal body that comes with a 2.5D curved glass covering the display, something that most smartphone makers have already adopted as a design standard these days. Despite of that, the F1S isn't a compact, lightweight, and slim smartphone that we are seeing these days. The phone measures 7.4mm thin and weighs 160 grams. It's a little cumbersome considering it has a 5.5-inch display. Oppo could have slimmed down the top screen bezel a little to make it more compact. However, my hand is thankfully large enough to manage the entire screen estate. My gestures are precisely recognized and I have no issues typing single-handedly. Even though the F1S shares the same display size as the F1 Plus, it produces a lower but still satisfying HD resolution on an IPS type panel as opposed to the latter's full HD and AMOLED display. The display still looks pretty good in real world. Viewing angles are good and it has great visibility under harsh sunlight. Try putting a higher resolution smartphone display side by side, you won't be able to tell that the phone has a lower screen resolution. The phone sports a fingerprint scanner that Oppo claims to recognize fingers and unlock the phone as fast as 0.22 seconds. It has no issues recognizing my fingers and unlocks almost instantly. The hardware also happens to be a physical home button as well, which gives you an option to glance at the time and notifications without pressing the power button and jumping into the home screen. Oppo has also made some commendable efforts, one of it being the phone's triple slot SIM tray. It accepts 2 nano SIM cards and 1 micro SD card without compromising space. This is rather convenient if you have 2 SIM cards and require to expand the phone's storage. On the other hand, Oppo has been rather kind to pre-apply a screen protection film on the phone and including a TPU case out of the box, saving a lot of trouble for hunting the phone's accessories. If you are the type of person looking forward to the most recent Android updates, this phone is definitely not for you. The F1S is still running on Android 5.1 Lollipop. However, Oppo has also loaded its latest iteration of ColorOS Launcher, which promises to be faster than stock Android software and previous ColorOS versions. You're still getting the same usability found on most Chinese Android smartphones, or put it simply, like iOS. Fortunately, the phone's software doesn't disappoint in terms of performance. I do not miss having Android Marshmallow, and stuffs such as permissions can still be managed through the Security Center app. Apps launch almost instantly, and there are some occasional lags in typing and scrolling, but overall, it is acceptable. On the other hand, there are a few things I love on the phone's software. The lock screen magazine shows a set of high-quality pictures, and I find it a joy to keep turning on and off the phone to see what comes next. You can configure it to show pictures according to your interests as well. The phone's fingerprint scanner has a few software tricks as well. You can configure your finger to either launch an app or call one of your contacts after unlocking the phone. Otherwise, you can encrypt apps and files stored on the phone, which is commonly found in many other devices. The F1S features Direct Power Sound, a software equalizer that aims to improve the audio listening experience on speakers or headphones. I was very impressed with the difference it delivers and have kept it enabled throughout the review period. Audio playback from the loudspeakers feel a lot more immersive with some warmth added. Once you plug in your headphones, you will be able to tune the sound quality to your liking. I totally love the F1S software experience. ColorOS 3.1 is well optimized just like how I've used to experience back on Oppo's older devices. While I do wish that Oppo could issue an Android Marshmallow or Nougat OTA update for the F1S to take advantage of some under-the-hood features. Let's wait for that to happen. As a selfie expert, the F1S does really intend to take on selfie point and shoots by dramatically increasing the resolution from the F1's 13 megapixel up to 16 megapixel. which technically means that you can have your selfies printed on a large billboard. But before we get too carried away with that, let's get back to the technical specs. The phone's selfie camera uses a 1 over 3.1 inch sensor size with an f2.0 aperture, which should be sufficient to give you some reasonably good looking photos when used in dim lighting. What's different here is the camera software. Oppo has added a skin beautification tag called Beautify 4.0. There are 7 levels of skin smoothing effect, and you can choose to have a fairer or rosier skin tone. Girls will definitely love these features, however, it doesn't work too well on my skin, mainly because my skin tone is rather fair by nature. Oppo's Beautify tag made me look like a zombie, and hence I decided not to use the beauty mode when I take selfies. In addition, the F1S camera software will let you trigger the shutter by detecting your palm and voice. The F1S selfie camera optics is a reasonably good one in its range. While it tends to overexpose my selfies in bright sunlight, it produces sharp and detailed pictures that you would expect from a higher resolution camera. When it comes to taking selfies in a dimly lit room, the camera increases its light sensitivity, otherwise uses the screen flash to make selfies look brighter. Noise and distortion is rather visible. In order to find out if the F1S is truly a selfie expert, I took out 2 other smartphones from our collection, namely the Honor 8 and Galaxy Note 5, which sports lower resolutions of 8MP and 5MP respectively on their selfie cameras. Both of these phones did better than the F1S in terms of overall picture quality with a more natural color tone, all thanks to better camera optics and software. Hence, the megapixels on the F1S don't really matter for taking good selfies. The 30MP main camera is a rather average one. It will work well in good lighting conditions, but produces a lot of noise and loses detail when it comes to low light. I don't usually favor MediaTek-powered devices when it comes to performance and benchmarks, but I have to admit that Oppo has done a great job in optimizing the phone's software to play well with the CPU. Benchmark scores show that the phone performs slightly slower than the Helio P10, but you shouldn't be hard-pressed with the phone's performance despite of the numbers. The F1S didn't disappoint in terms of battery life. Oppo traded for a larger battery on the phone for the Volt Fast Charge technology that is available on the F1 Plus, which is actually rather annoying when it comes to charging the phone. On a moderate use, the phone will usually get me past the day, and I'll usually need to charge the phone at the start of my working day. It takes around 3 hours to get from 0 to 100%, so you really need to exercise some patience. The Oppo F1S is no doubt the only smartphone that comes with the highest resolution selfie camera. Its beauty mode does tend to make ladies look prettier and works fine even in low light. But to consider as a selfie expert, Oppo still has a lot of work to do in offering more features on its software other than just a skin smoothing feature. The phone retails at ringgit 1198 and it should literally attract most selfie lovers out there. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video review of the Selfie Expert. We would like to thank Cafe Lafayette for sponsoring us this location for this shoot, so make sure you visit them at Damansara Uptown for the perfect selfie experience. Once again, I'm Warren for KL Gadget TV. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't done so. Follow us on social media, otherwise you can follow me on Twitter or Instagram at The Warren Lee. I'll see you in the next one.